What's up, folks? Everybody who wants to be better in Rocket League trains. They train on free play, custom maps, workshop maps, but there's one thing that can decide if you will actually improve. I'm talking about a good interpretation of training. It's actually everything you have to do to rank up, to improve, to basically play better. And you have to do it. Warm-up isn't enough. Playing games isn't enough too. Hopping to Rocket League and going to training. But training has to be performed correctly because your improving process will be very slow. So, you have to know how, when and what to train. That's why I prepared this video. Because today, we'll talk about how should you train if you want to actually improve. If you like this video so far, consider subscribing and joining my Discord server. Link of course in the description. Firstly, we have to divide this video into few sections, which will be training of shooting, defending, air dribbling and dribbling, with some kinda area control too. Every of those parts will influence something in your gameplay, so it's very important to remember about all of those. Those are the most useful things to train too, because there's actually a way to grind those mechanics, unlike training recovery for example. We'll start from shooting because it's one of the most underestimated things to train in Rocket League. I don't know to be honest why. But before, I have to say this. Download bakkesmod and run it. It really, really makes your training better and you'll have higher angle of possibilities during a normal custom game training. It's necessary and irreplaceable, so if you can, so you play on PC, do it. You will thank me later, I promise. What should you know about shooting training? First of all, it's not that easy. It's not about going into training and banging the ball as powerful as you can. You actually have to try to improve yourself. What I mean is to see what you are doing bad about it. Arrow shots are very important in this case because they allow you to shoot more precisely, but not every time. Sometimes it's better to shoot with your car face straight instead of making it difficult. It's all about how the ball is moving and how your car is faced before a shot. For example, if you are facing straight and the ball is coming from right, when the net is on right too, probably the best way would be to lean right top spot of your car and dodge diagonally right. Best power and best accuracy. But when the ball is going straight at you fast and the net is straight to you too, best way probably will be to not use any arrow, just jump, aim middle part of your car straight to the ball and dodge just forward. Nothing spectacular needed and it's really really not that difficult, just simple shot. That's why you have to grind some of those shots. If you see that a simple side dodge shot isn't effective, try other options. And you have a lot of possible angles of your car. You just have to find this right path and just grind it out. And about arrow shots, these are very important too. Some of the angles are just impossible without them, so I recommend you to grind them as much as you can. They are good not only for shooting, you will benefit a lot from passes and clears too. Lastly, just for beginners, try to notice your dodge after hit. These are kinda common in lower ranks, so you probably have this problem, but you haven't done anything to stop it. You have to dodge second time before your car touches the ball, because if you do it the opposite way, the ball won't catch as much momentum as it could. Just grind shots out and it will be better. Next thing about shooting is recovery after shot. That's very, very underestimated because when you shoot, you expect a goal. Okay, that's fair. But you can always miss, shot too low, or just your opponent will just defend the coming ball. What you will do then? Probably lose all momentum and bounce off the ground couple of times and by the time you'll go back, your teammate loses a goal. Just after every shot, take a look at your car and see how it behaves. Try to move it more left, right to recover better. It will help you in long term, believe me. How and where to train all those things? On PC, custom training and aim training on workshop maps. On consoles, custom maps only. Fast shots, clears, wall shots, angle shots, arrow shots, every of those training will be useful in your training routine. That's basically how a good shooting training should look like. Defending is very important to grind too and it's actually a lot easier to grind than shooting. Because all you have to do is position yourself good, sometimes in the net, sometimes outside of the net. How should you know when to do it first way and when to do it second way? Just by grinding. Yeah, when you can't defend coming shot by standing outside of the net, try to go a little bit inside of it and then you'll be able to defend it. Probably. About fast aerials on defense, it's not always the best way of defending the ball. When the ball is going straight above you and is going fast, worst thing you can do is to make a fast aerial. Fast era always leads to going forward, and in this scenario, you rather would like to go straight up instead of behind the ball. So just jump twice, then lean your car as high as it's possible, and then start to boost. Better way and no possible way to miss the ball. Very important thing is to keep your boost amount on certain levels during defense, because you will have very hard times without boost on defense. But it's not always crucial to use boost during defense. If the ball is going straight at you or just a little above you, you probably want to lean your car the way it bounced to the corner, and you won't have to use any boost to do that. Just jumping will do the work. Despite the fact that you don't need boost to defend, it's very good to maintain momentum when you are rotating back post. With high level momentum, you'll be more likely to clear the ball to the corner, which is very important, and just reach the ball, because if you are moving fast, you fly high faster too. It's kinda hard to train on free play, but you just have to remember that during your custom training session, that it won't look like this every time. Lastly, it's very important, always try to clear the ball to the left or right side instead of up to the backboard. Backboard clears when your teammates are gone are very dangerous, because it's rather easy to read a ball coming off the backboard, especially considering the fact that today we have a lot of training packs for backboard shots, so just don't make it easy for your opponents. Edge dribbling is one of the most trained ability in Rocket League, just because it's very flashy and relatively easy to train, because the ball always goes to the net, and we can pretend to be squishy muffins. Anyway, dribbling training. You just have to aim for the best setup, either is ground air dribble or wall air dribble. If you can't drag the ball correctly, firstly focus on bouncing good off the wall, for example. After you will be able to take off correctly, dragging the ball won't be the biggest problem. Just grinding out setups will truly help you in training air dribbles, thus ball control in the air. Okay, now something for beginners. If you want to grind some air dribbles, focus on moving forward backward firstly, before doing normal air dribbles. Just find a training where the ball and the car is fitting straight to the goal. You won't have to steer left and right, and it will be easier for beginning. Best grind is wise grind, remember. Yeah, Liqu. Liqu said that. Most important are of course corrections during air dribble. If you won't manage to go straight up with the car, turn it around. If it won't work too, turn it to the side. It really depends how to do air dribbles, because you won't be always in one position. Either it's in a match or it's just a training. And to learn how to correctly move your car in the air, use workshop maps. And if you're playing on consoles, I have one little training, just wait a second. You have to find a map which is related to ring, for example Letterman's ring map, and go through it. Try to control your car the best you can, and try to get better and better time every training session. It will definitely help you to control your car in the air, and drag of the ball will be much easier for you. And for console players, remember to just fly around the ball. With ball came on, with ball came off, it doesn't matter. Flying around the ball will just help you to learn car control almost the same way as rings will do. So summarizing, grind mainly setup and grind other angles of air dribbling, that's it. Grinding dribbling is IMO 4th most important thing to do on training, that's why you should grind it almost every time you train on free play. Grinding dribbles is all about making little movements when the ball is on your head. All you have to do is to not shake your car panically, but just take the ball in your head, see where the circle is under your car, position yourself in the center of the circle and stop moving. I mean, still go forward, but stop wiggling like a jelly. If you can't do this, you have to practice first delicate turning. And if you will be able to do it, let's go into serious training now. Just watch if the ball is slightly touching your front mask, before if it isn't, you will be likely to perform a Athena flick, which is bad. You have to grind those corrections and you'll be good to go. Next thing is use less and less boost. To be honest, to perform dribbling with the ball, you don't have to use any boost. Boost is used only if you want to make a flick and when the ball will just go too much on your mask. That's because you have to be very smooth and gentle with movements of your car. Being smoother equals better flicks. Okay, now into training. You have a lot of workshop maps related to dribbling, which is great, but you probably play on console too, so I would say custom training. There's a lot of custom trainings in which you will have to control the ball just from the beginning, because the ball will bounce straight at your car. Those are the best in my opinion, and you will learn how to position the ball on your car in just like to match situations. That's how you should train dribbles. Aerials will be the next thing and last thing to practice during your training session. This is quite complicated, not gonna lie. We have a lot of things to take care of. Most important is to shoot the ball with front bumper, not wheels. But not every time. You have to grind a lot of aerials to finally find a good way of shooting certain angles and certain passes, because in aerial game nothing is the same. Firstly, try to shoot the ball with your car in normal position. If it won't work, rotate it around or to the side. Grind it in every way. Then see if it's not lacking in some aspects. Maybe too long power, maybe the path to the ball was too long. Very important is to see if one aerial boost that you will have in a normal match is even enough to get to the ball the way you do it. If you downloaded bakkesmod earlier, you just have to set boost to limited and try to do it with 90-80 boost. But it's not everything. Aerials are very hard because it's hard to aim the ball on higher side of the net. Shooting through the ground is rather easy, but it's an easy save for me too. That's why the most people on higher level decide to go for double touch instead of simple aerial. It's just easier to aim the ball to the backboard. But okay, how to train it then? Custom training. Yeah, you probably didn't know this. Many trainings related to redirects or just simply aerial training are good with or even without bakkesmod. Summarizing, we are aware of our boost during training, aim for higher sides of the net instead of ground, and most importantly, hit the ball with front of your car. Okay, I think it's everything about this video. I hope that after some time you'll improve like you never before. So if you like my video, like it, subscribe to my channel. It motivates me a lot to make more videos with better quality. Remember, it's only a game. Bye bye.